Men, we have come together on a most serious matter. We're at war. Our national existence and our liberties are at stake. They can be preserved only by dependence upon the efficient operation of our military intelligence and our counterintelligence services. The first of these jobs involves finding out everything we can about the enemy. We are taking care of that. The second one consists in keeping the enemy from finding out what our plans are. That's harder. That's harder because we make it hard for ourselves. We have not learned yet to keep our mouths shut. That's some fact that the enemy would like to know. Individual facts may not seem to be important. But if the enemy gets all of these, he can piece them together, have a picture of all our plans and intentions. Regard each one of these facts as you would a gun. Do not be placed in the position of saying, I didn't know it was loaded. We are playing a desperate game. We are playing it for keeps. With only one currency, human life, your life and mine. The film which you are about to see was made by the British government to show British soldiers and British civilians what they are up against. We face a somewhat similar problem. The enemy has long ears. He's keen on getting information. He stops at nothing to get. That getting information is something if where he makes the effort, we may contribute and help him out. We must avoid it by keeping our mouths shut. If we say nothing, the enemy cannot hear. Let us keep our mouths shut.
Germans have begun to use our harbor as a base for submarines.
Since when?
Last week. People are furious. They can do nothing.
How many troops are there here?
Only a few.
A battalion?
Perhaps.
Captain Mercier. How do you do?
How do you do?
Well, any luck?
I think I have the information you require. Here is my full report on the German coastal defenses in northern and western France.
Splendid. Won't you sit down? Anything special?
The Germans have begun to use Norville as a base de sous-marin.
Submarine base?
Norville.
That's only a village.
But it has a good harbor.
This is the one?
strong are the defenses there?
There is only one battalion of troops in the town and a few naval technicians.
I see. And the coast?
It is very thinly held for 15 miles on either side of the town. There are no tanks, no heavy guns. In fact, there is no substantial body of troops within 80 miles.
No troops within 80 miles? Lord, for an important base, it's very lightly held.
Yes, but probably with the hope that it won't attract our attention.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much, Captain Mercier. We're extremely grateful.
At your service.
Goodbye, sir.
We'll keep in touch.
That settles it.
Norville. If we can put pay to the German base there, that ought to make those shipping figures take a turn for the better. How many men shall we need?
Brigade group should be enough.
Right. I'll put that up to the Chief of Staffs at once. If they agree, we can get the men off at night and land them at dawn on these beaches and somewhere here.
Then they could make their way round, mop up the Boche battalion, and hold the place while the sappers blow up these stores, oil dumps, lock gates, everything else is there. I think the whole show should take, well, how long? 12 hours?
Good. That means we get them off again that night.
Mm. The 95th Brigade's standing by. They're fully trained. We can send them up to the new training area at Watercombe, put them through their final rehearsal.
There shouldn't be any difficulty in getting them down to the channel. And we can slip them into a convoy going to the Near East. When the time comes, they can break away with a destroyer escort.
You know, if the Boche got onto this, it'd be goodbye to the brigade. What we need is a full-time security officer on this job to ensure secrecy. Richards would be the man for him. I'll see if they'll let us have him. Hello? Oh, Richard. We want you to cover the 95th Brigade for security.
What are you going to do with them, sir?
We are sending them up to Watercombe to do special training to go out on a special job.
Watercombe? That's near Westport, isn't it? Mm. Who's the Brigadier?
Blunt, a grand fellow. Brigade headquarters at Newby.
I'd better go and contact him right away. I suppose you can't give me any sort of idea what kind of a job it is I'm going to do.
We're planning a raid for them.
We don't want it to be a suicide squad.
You know who I am?
No, sir.
Well, then oughtn't you to have asked me for my pass?
I thought you was with the Brigadier, sir.
Well, I'm not. I might be an enemy agent for all you know.
Now come in. My name's Richards.
All right. You're the security man, aren't you?
Yes, that's right. We were expecting you. My name's Harcourt, you know. This is Johnston, our intelligence officer.
Hello. How do you do?
Well, you better see the Brigadier right away. He'll be free in a minute.
Good.
Oh, by the way, I just ticked off that sentry of yours just now. He never asked me for my pass. Well, he doesn't know me from Adam. I hope you don't mind.
No, not at all. He ought to have known better. I'll talk to his CO. 10th Chilterns, isn't he?
Yes, Cooper's his CO.
Just take this stuff back to your CO, Cummings. Tell him I'll come round in the morning and discuss it with him.
Right, sir. All right, sir.
Oh, not that one. Just listen to this.
Oh, this is Richard, sir, the security man.
Oh, how do you do, Richard? I'm glad to see you. As a matter of fact, this is something in your line.
Yes, sir. I understand that you're moving from Newby to Watercombe. May I point out that we have a branch near there at Westport as well as at Newby. We shall be pleased to carry out any orders you may be good enough, and so on.
The wine merchant.
Now, how the devil did he find out?
The men know nothing of it. I'm certain of that, sir.
What do you think, Richard?
I wonder, sir, if it was mentioned in the mess.
You mean the mess corporal might have heard?
Anyway, just check up on it. There must be a leakage somewhere.
Right.
Come along in, Richard. Oh, by the way, you might tell the battalion they're getting 7 days' leave. Tell them to work out their own spread over.
Does that mean to...
It means just 7 days' leave.
Then you're going to find me an awful ruddy nuisance.
7 days' leave? Perhaps that means we're going overseas at last.
As you see, our security certainly needs tightening up. Of course, we're going to Watercombe, as you probably know. But we want the men to think they're going out east. The leave is a blind. We're even going to issue them with tropical equipment. Sit down.
Thanks, sir.
Now, is there anything else we can do?
Well, sir,
The important thing is security in the initial stages. Once the enemy gets to know there's something on, it's fairly easy for him to find out what it is.
You're right. I'll talk to the officers and NCOs before leave starts.
And I suggest that you begin censorship right away. Postal and telegraph. The men oughtn't to be allowed to use letterboxes or post offices.
Well, we can put that into operation today. You know, I'm looking forward to this show, Richards. It's come just in time to prevent any chance of the brigade getting stale. You better start in right away and let me know where you think we're weakest.
No pleasing some people. What do you think, Johnny?
Around and see you before the end of the show. Before all the others come barging in. Possibly my last chance.
Your last? Oh, damn, that's the end of the whiskey. Ma, be a lot and run through the back way to the Bull and get me a refill.
All right, dear.
Oh, yeah, let me pay for it.
What do you mean, last chance? I've got another week here yet.
Oh, I know you have, but I haven't.
Oh, don't tell me that awful old war office is moving you.
I'm afraid so.
Oh, but darling, why do they have to pick on you?
Well, it's not only me, it's the whole brigade.
Oh, hell.
Now, look here. For God's sake, don't tell anyone, but I rather believe we're going to do some sort of special training first.
Well, where will you be then?
Well, that I'm afraid I can't tell you because it's hush-hush.
Oh, what a shame. You see, I'm leaving the show at the end of next week. Doing the act solo in variety. I might have got a date near where you're going to be.
Do you mean you really would?
Look, you don't have to tell me any of your precious military secrets, because I'm a German spy. But they're my provincial dates. If you're going to be near any one of those, maybe...
I say...
Careful.
Oh, don't be an ass, darling. Look, you couldn't make Westport a week or two earlier, could you?
Westport? I might. I'll try and fix it with my manager.
Well, that's fine, because if you could be at Westport when the brigade's training at Waterkham... What could be better?
Ma, oh, dear. Such a job to get it, too.
Just in time. Oh, you must drink to our last meeting, mustn't we?
Oh, that's all right, Ma. You can keep that.
Oh, thank you, sir. You better get changed. You're on in a few minutes.
All right, Ma.
Huh? Here's to au revoir.
Cheers.
Come on, come on, come on. Now then, darling, out you go.
Okay. Well, with any luck, I'll see you at...
Ma's a German spy, too, you know.
Good night.
Good night. Well?
Did he tell you anything? They're moving.
I know that.
They're going overseas.
I know that, too.
Seems I've been wasting my time.
Well, the men don't know when they're going. Only the officers know that.
Funny. He didn't mention it.
Oh, yes, he did. Come on. hell, I'm sick and tired of the whole lousy racket. Do your own dirty work for a change.
Listen, hamburger.
Oh, bitch!
All right. This is where we part. I hope you can get your coke ration from somewhere else.
I'll give it up. It's only a habit anyway.
Oh, no, Miguel. Cocaine's a habit you can't give up. I've tried, and I know. Ta-ta. Pleasant dreams and a couple of aspirins.
Wait a minute. They're not going overseas yet. They're going to Watercombe for special training.
Are you sure of that?
Yes. I told him I'd try and make Westport a couple of weeks earlier, so I'd go over and see him. Some hopes he's got.
I don't know so much.
Your call is there.
Coming. Coming. Have I got everything?
Whatever you may be, in pubs or buses, or in the car when someone gives you a lift, or even chatting with friends and relatives, take it for granted that everyone you meet may, deliberately or unconsciously, give you away to the other side. Now, you all know what a traitor is. A traitor is a man who deliberately gives away his side to the enemy. But a patriot can easily do as much harm as a traitor. He can do it by letting slip some unimportant tuppenny-halfpenny detail that may have no value in itself, whatever. But that detail may be the one clue that gives a meaning to several other details, equally small. Together, those details may make sense. They may reveal to the enemy that some big move is on. So think twice before talking about military affairs. When in doubt, say nothing. Even if saying nothing makes you look a fool. Every time you positively check yourself, you're helping to win the war. That's what I want to ram home to every man jack of you. Bear it in mind all the time you're on leave. And after. Drum it into your men. Tell them anything they say may get back to Germany. I don't say it always will, but it may.
Gentlemen, we have your reports from the Auslands Bureau on its work in Brazil. A similar report from Mexico. And another from Afghanistan. All this is good, gentlemen, as far as it goes. But what I want is new facts. No matter how small. From small facts, there often spring big ideas. Come. Yes, Horn?
Excellency, I have just received a radio report from England that the 95th Brigade is proceeding to a new training area at Watercombe before going overseas.
Watercombe? Where is that? Ah, near Westport. That is where the big convoys start from. Very interesting. What do we know about the 95th Brigade?
It is a normal brigade, Excellency. Commander, Brigadier Blunt, an efficient soldier with a distinguished record against us in the last war, and new personnel has been posted to the brigade.
And now Watercombe. You see, gentlemen, a new fact. Well done, Horn. It may mean nothing. On the other hand, who have we working for us at Watercombe?
No one, Excellency. Our men are all engaged in watching convoys at Westport, but our woman agent reports she is following up the information.
You cannot rely on that. Someone must be sent immediately. Send two men. We must have details of equipment as well as of the type of training. There are some good men working on the refresher course at this moment.
This is number 23, Herr Oberstleutnant.
Number 23. You know England well?
I was in business in the north of England for 10 years, until shortly before the war.
Good. So you have a complete English outfit. Here are your papers. You'll be landed by rubber boat from one of our U-boats at some part of the English coast. You will then find your way to Mr. Barrett, our agent, a bookseller in Westport. He will give you further instructions. Meanwhile, study those and await your sailing orders. That's all.
This is number 16, Herr Oberstleutnant.
Number 16. You will travel to England by air and land by parachute after dark. I understand you know England well.
I was a clerk at an oilage contractor's.
Here are your papers.
What's yours?
Oh, don't mind if I do.
Brother?
Mm-hmm. You're Brother,
are you on leave, old chap?
Yes, Rock.
What unit?
10, Chilton.
Oh, I know, the 95th, aren't they?
That's right.
What company, you know, man?
Headquarters.
Been with them long?
Since November 1939.
Oh, that's funny. I've been with the headquarters company of the 10th Chilton's for over 6 months. I've never seen him before. Who's the CEO?
You're running suspicious, aren't you?
Go on, who is he?
Chap called Cooper.
Oh, that's right, isn't it? You was out in France with him when he won the MC.
That's right.
Only it wasn't the MC, it was the DSO, wasn't it?
What's the matter, old chap? You absent without leave?
No, of course not. He just running nosy, that's all.
Well, so you be. If you had 7 days CB for getting the right man right, God knows what would happen to me if I got the wrong man wrong. Well, so long, chap.
Yes, sir. That bloke was never in my company.
Excuse me, sir. Could I have a word with you?
What do you want?
There's a chap in the buffet bar. Says he's in the 10th Chilton's. And he ain't.
How do you know?
Oh, because I'm in the 10th Chilton's, sir.
Well, you know everybody in the battalion?
No, sir. But he says he's in the headquarters company, and that's my company. I've never seen him before.
Well, who do you think he is?
Well, I don't know, sir. But he might be a German spy.
A German spy? How do you imagine he got here?
Well, I couldn't say, sir. But the papers say there's been some parachutes come down.
All right, fetch him in.
Very good, sir. If you're on the level, you've got nothing to worry about. There he is, sir.
All right, come in.
Go on, get in.
Let me see your pay book.
Sir?
What is your regiment?
10th Battalion, Chilton, sir.
Where are you stationed?
Newby.
And before that?
Tidworth, sir.
No, sir. We was in Norwich till March.
He doesn't know what he's talking about, sir.
Oh, we'll soon see about that. Close the door. Take off your blouse.
Oh, me?
Yes, you.
Okay, sir. There you are, sir.
Now your shirt.
My shirt, sir?
Yes, your shirt. And don't try to be funny. Now your vest. Take off your vest.
Look, sir.
Perishing harness marks.
Come on, back. He's in my
own. He must have landed within the last 24 hours.
Well, I'll be damned.
Excuse me, sir. Could you tell me if I'm on the right road to Westport?
Sure. Turn left here.
Are you going my way? Would you care for a lift?
It's very kind of you. I thought of catching the bus at the crossroads.
You should have checked up on me before telling me the way like that. For all you know, I might be a German spy or something.
Good morning, sir.
I want to see the proprietor. I have a book here which I'm anxious to sell.
Just a moment,
There's a gentleman outside, Mr. Byron. He wants you to buy this book.
Yes. Yes, very interesting. Ask him to wait a moment, will you?
Mr. Byron, it will not be long.
Thank you.
I've got a client who might like to buy it. Will you come inside? By the way, I don't know your name.
Davis. My papers are all in order. I understood I should get further instruction from you.
Yes, that's right. Sit down, will you? Oh, sit down.
Thank you. You're lucky. No thanks, no.
Here, go on.
Thank you. That girl of yours, she isn't English?
No, she's a Dutch refugee. You see, Westport's always known me as an anti-Nazi. So is she, for that matter. She's a useful cover. If she should get to know anything, her parents are in Rotterdam. The Gestapo can always take them under its protection. Now to business. You go to Watercombe, a little place down the coast here. You stay at the White Hart Hotel. I've booked a room there for you.
In the name of Davis?
Yes. The 95th Brigade is expected in Watercombe in about 3 days' time. You will be comfortably settled in before they arrive.
If I want anything urgently, what shall I do?
You ring this number, Westport 77250. Ask for Ned. It'll be me. Talk about family affairs. What identity papers have you brought with you?
I've them here.
Ration book, identity card, driving license, passport. God, our people are thorough. Every detail just as I sent it over. Yeah, you should be all right with those. It's the safest alibi we can find for you.
Copy of my account.
Don't! How wonderful! I thought you did go back. Did you miss your train?
Couldn't have known I was coming. You didn't wait.
Oh, what will you do now?
Get the next one on the 3-day CV, I expect. I say, oughtn't you to...
She's reading Gone with the Wind. A chapter at a time.
Yes, nice. That'll be Gone with the Wind, too, if I don't want to miss the next one.
Write to me before you sail.
Of course.
And send me your address as soon as you get there.
You all that last night. Besides, you know, you people here aren't exactly outside the war zone.
I will write. You know I will.
Better.
Are you taking that book, madam?
Oh! Whatever came over me? I don't want it at all.
Anything wrong, Miss Lehman?
A customer seemed to think our books were free.
They'll fetch quite high prices, don't they, Mr. Davis? Good day to you.
Goodbye, Bessie.
Goodbye.